welcome back to week three, everybody, where I'm still on the bow. I think I've actually reaching a new record here for longest time on a weapon without changing. Yeah, it's kind of weird. I really am enjoying the bow, and even through those tough times, I still sort of feel like this is the right playstyle for me. I like how it's really mobile and fluid. But yeah, it's been interesting. Like, some days this week have been rough mentally, where I've thought, man, I'm not improving, my aim still sucks, you know. Maybe, like, I just don't have the aim for this, but then other days I feel like my aim is laser focused and I'm playing really well, but the playstyle of the bow I really enjoy and it keeps bringing me back. Majors have been my big problem this week, so, but we'll get into all of that shortly. Actually, how about we get into it now? This is day one of week three, and this is one of my big problems. So basically, I'd say Majors and Sword and Shield are kind of like my two problem areas. Sword and Shield, because they can just leap right on you. They've got instant stuns. They get that horrible fucking slow on you. So this guy I fought six times, and I'd lost like five in a row. But I think one of the important things to do is to keep fighting them and sort of try to develop some tactics. I have since, subsequently to this duel, realized that blocking is a big help against Sword and Shield, because then they can't do anything to you, and then you can carry on kiting them. Alas, with Sword and Shield, if you're not going to block, you basically just have to kite them so hard that they can't even get within that range of, like, getting the stun on you. So that's what I had to do, and I don't like playing like that because I feel really ratty. I like the idea of kind of fighting up close, but with Sword and Shield, I just don't know any other... Like, with block, it helps a little bit, but you really just have to stay out of their range and then keep getting little pot shots up on them. That obviously works for duels and OPR. A little bit difficult because they can heal up. But just got to keep fighting them. It's got to be a strat. It's got to be a strat to beating them. My other big issue is just my aim. It's definitely improving. Like, there's no doubt that it's getting better. But when I need it the most, like right here, I have this guy low. And then he just runs away and I can't shoot at him. But I get him low again. And, yeah, following up, once you've got that burst off and then, look, I get him really low, and then I just can't fucking finish him off, although I do get stuck on, like, right here! If I could just land that next shot, but I just lose my confidence and my abilities. So then he just runs off. So many fights I just don't end up killing the person because of my lack of aim. And then it happens again, where he comes out to attack me, and then I get him really low, but then I just can't finish it off, which is kind of frustrating. So I definitely just want to keep trying to improve that aim. So it's pretty close, he's getting me quite low, I'm getting him quite low, but then I get a few more attacks on him here. So there, he has to really back up, because he is one shot away. It's a me problem, I realize that, it's a me problem. But I prefer situations like this, where they get trapped. This is the funniest thing, you can't get out. I just light attack him to death. I don't know whose ass you're playing on an evening, but it ain't dinner time, buddy. So Yoda gave me some more training. So if you remember last week, I was trying to practice my animation cancel, so you can get basically to like a heavy attack into a light attack off really, really quickly. So it's like kind of two shots, a short space of time. So I've been working on that all week. I do feel like I'm getting there. I still, the heat of the moment, I still stuff it up. So the muscle memory still needs a little bit more time to get there. But it's definitely way better than what it was. But then, so Kaz was kind of like saying to me, okay, so now you need to do your animation cancel and start folding in, like, your rapier attacks, you know? And one of the things I learned through the duels was you want to fold in your rapier attacks, but you don't want to blow through them all in one go. You kind of want to do one. You want to always sort of have one up, because then that, because it sort of works like you'll do some bow attacks, you'll do your animation cancel, so you do your heavy attack, animation cancel, light attack, then you'll kind of fold in a rapier attack, and then by that time your stamina's come back to full, and then you can do another round of the animation cancel. So that's kind of how I've been doing it. So yeah, remember, Kaz has a YouTube channel, I'll put it in the description. But this is kind of ultimately what I am trying to do, which he shows me here on me. So he's just going to go for his animation cancels, do some light attacks on the rapier, and then back into some animation cancels. So just switching it up. So of course, my first blimmin' dueling session after that was with NotZ, who's one of the best bow players on the server. So I'm trying to get in my rapier decks, but he just tears me apart. But he's a really nice guy too. It's always like the good players that are the nice ones. And he gave me some good tips also. But the rapier attacks came a little bit better, and after losing four in a row, I actually ended up winning one, which, and when I'm dueling right now, I'm kind of happy. Ah, see, I just blew my blimmin' trading shot there, which isn't good. Yeah, you can see me trying to get my rapier attacks here stupidly. So you can see I'm still trying to figure it out, but I actually managed to win this one, which is good. I end up winning 2 out of 11, but hey, look, he's a good bow player. So I go from one good player to another good bow player. I actually don't know, so I, after a while I got used to folding in the rapier attacks with melee, but I don't quite know how to do it against range, especially mages. So I win that one, but I won 5 fights and he won 9. I just don't have confidence in my aim, so when I go against other ranged players, it makes me a lot more nervous than if I'm, say, fighting like a melee. With a melee, I'm a little bit more confident in my abilities. You'll really see it showcased here, like mages as well. They're like, I just don't know what to do against them. They just seem to have the big AoEs that can just drop on you. They can fire at you from a distance and faster. I know that bows can beat them, obviously, but man, they're like such a counter. But I had a really good dueling session with one of these mages from my guild, and we actually had 28 fights, and it was split right down the middle. We won 50-50. The key is definitely to fold in those rapier attacks, but also to stay calm and not like get flustered, so that you can actually land your shots. But yeah, man, we had some good fights. This is, my heart was racing. Dueling 100% helps though. Like if you've been dueling all day, you'll just notice that like, your aim just getting way more on point, and you'll go into OPR and you'll be like a laser. Like, I had a duel with this guy right after those mage fights. I had 28 duels, and my aim was just really on point. And I ended up winning every duel we had. I think we had, like, about 10 duels, and I won every one. And it was just because, like, I was aiming really well. I was calm. Yeah, you just kind of get your head in the game. Also, this time I was, like, folding some of those rapier attacks to pressure them a little bit better as well. But, yeah, I still need to figure out how to do the rapier against other ranged players, because I'm sure I'm not doing it right. Then I fought Not Z. Now, he's not on his bow this time, he's on a blunderbuss. But he's a good player, and I managed to beat him 10-5, so I was feeling pretty good about that, because I wouldn't have been able to do that a week ago. See, well, you duel more, and then you aim, you just get your eye in. I mean, you kind of see that I've been dueling all day, and you can just see that my aim at this point is, like, I'm hitting a lot of my shots. And I'm getting those rapier attacks off good, too. But then, the legend emerges, El Mechanico. This guy's probably the best, or one of the best duelers on the server, definitely. Best melee. He's been in lots of dueling competitions and just, like, keeps winning all the time. So... But he's an awesome, awesome dude. Like, he's been actually really supportive and helpful, and he's been giving me these tips in Discord, like Kaz has. So it's always like the guys that are like the most badass that are also like the most helpful and want to see you succeed, you know what I mean? So it's kind of cool. But we had some jewels with him. So it was good. When you're fighting a top tier player like this, you do pick up stuff really quickly. Like, first of all, he was chasing after me and he was just getting on me and killing me, so I started folding in my animation cancels really well, like kind of just knowing the distance where I could quickly spin around, getting the hit off him with my bow, and then still have enough safe distance. So that was starting to help, and that kind of helped me in my fights. Then, after a while, I was starting to kind of fold in those rapier attacks. So like getting a quick rapier attack on them, and then getting away, and then using your bow skills again, so I was getting them closer. So even though I was getting beaten every time, it felt good, because I was like, well, I'm firing well, I'm getting my shots off, you know, I'm getting those rapier attacks in, like I'm playing how I should be playing, even though I just ran myself at a stem there. So it actually felt good, and I felt like I was learning quite a lot from the fights, so that was good. But then, ladies and gentlemen, it all came together. And I'll just show you the fight here without saying anything. I've never, ever beaten him before, so that was a first. This coming week, I really want to focus on mages, because I just find them so hard to fight. I need to develop some strats. They just, yeah, I don't know. I find them really, really, really tough, so that's what I want to focus on. So I had some folks here. I actually did better than I thought. I thought I lost almost every fight, but actually I won 5 of them and he won 8. So the big problem I have with mages is when you get close to them, they can ice shower you, and then you get caught, and then they can fireball you. But I'm noticing when I've gone back and looked at all my wins, I get caught in the ice shower, but then I flourish and finish forward, and then I'm able to finish them off because I'm out of the CC. I think one of the things that makes mages so strong is when you get close to them, they can drop all those AoEs on you so easily. But if you get really aggressive with the rapier, you can also apply the same kind of pressure. So again, here I get caught in that ice storm, but I'm able to flourish and finish my way out of it, and then I put him into a stagger. And then I can just rapier him to death, basically. So almost every time I'm winning, I'm being really aggressive. And even if I do get caught, I've got an answer for it. So I don't get out of the ice shell this time, but I'm able to use my bow. So he catches me, but then I can just use my explosive shot. See, in this one, I don't press forward, and he catches me in the ice, and I don't press forward, and I try to back up, and then I'm basically easy pickings at that stage, because I'm not putting them under any pressure. I get caught here, and then I'm trying to back up. I do get an attack on him, but he puts the AoE, and then I'm just trying to back up, and yeah, he's able to just finish me off. Fuck. Alright, so I thought I'd show you my build video, because this is as close to finished as it's gonna get, and I'm probably not gonna update it anytime soon until like the season changes or anything like this. So I've been trying to stack dexterity as much as I can, so I've had to make some small sacrifices, mainly because I wanted, sometimes I go into OPR with like 100 con, so I've had to pick something with dex on it when there might have been something better with con on it. So for the weapon, I've chosen a Boreal Attunement, Kingly Dragon, and Enchanted. For the rapier, I've chosen a Boreal Attunement, Vicious Omnidirectional Invade. For both of them, I've chosen a Split Gem, because we've been dueling and a lot of people run thrust resistance, and so having a Split Gem will get past that. I've chosen, this is the head. I'm trying to stack Elemental Evasion where I can. If not, I'll try to get Physical Evasion and then just try to make the gems work. So here I've got Elemental Evasion, Critical Retribution, and Resilience. On here I've got Freedom, Physical Evasion, and Resilience. On here I've got Freedom, Elemental Evasion, and Resilience. On this we've got Elemental Evasion, Shuriken Energy, and Resilience. And on here we've got Physical Evasion, Freedom, and Resilience. And each of the gems I'm using, fast damage absorption and an increase in ranged damage. So how much freedom do I actually have? I think I've got 3. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, because 4 doesn't make any difference. You want either 5 or 3. And really, in the end, you don't want to be getting caught by these melee boys anyway, because I have no slash resistance. I basically go all thrust resistance or fire damage resistance, so I try to play it where I don't get caught. So you'll see that I have a lot of thrust resistance and I have some fire gems like here and here. For the amulet, I've got stamina recovery, health, and shuriken and power. I've got invigorated punishment, thrust damage, and hardy for my ring, and I've got healthy toast, refreshing, and refreshing toast as my earring. And then those are my resistances. So you got to take into account the elemental evasion I've got on, and so I've got 3 elemental evasion and 2 physical evasion, and I run detonate as my heart rune at the moment, but I'm going to start mixing that up a little bit. I want to try cannon and grasping vines as well. So that's it's just fun bombing people, you know what I'm saying. For my attributes, I will run, sometimes I'll either run 100 con, and then I'll just have straight up dexterity food. So then I'll get to about 400 dexterity if I have the 40, you know, dexterity food. It'll take me up to 400. Or I don't generally go 150. I either go 100 con or 200 con. Like if I'm dueling, I'll go 200 con, and then the rest of dexterity. And if I'm going into OPR, sometimes I'll go 200 con, or sometimes, most of the time, I'll go 100 con and the rest of dexterity. So yeah, I haven't got any food. That's why it's 360 at the moment. And then the trait. Right, so the traits, I don't know if this is the best way to have set it up, but Yeah, I'll just copy this right now. I know that I can increase my damage by getting that on. That was just like, I've been, yeah, it's probably not the best setup in the world, but at the moment it's working for me. But let me know if you've got any tips on how you'd change that up. I'm sure there'll be some people coming to you going, what the hell have you got this and that? But this is what I'm running at the moment. This is really, really important because that's what you use for animation cancelling, so it has to go on. I like Rain of Arrows for OPR, but for Julian, I feel like it gets me into more trouble trying to cast it than it's worth. So I actually think it's almost worth running Evade Shot for Jules instead of this. So yeah. But like, this is all sort of stuff. I'll probably talk a little bit more about this because I actually wouldn't mind trying Poison Shot as well. So I'll test all these things out and kind of mix it up and change it. And then with the Rapier, it's pretty standard. Where the hell is it? There. Yes, I do need to level it up to 20. I keep forgetting. So just everything down here, you can see everything. I'm pretty much just going all into here. And then I've gone for Flourish and Finish as well. Obviously, I don't need that because I'm not doing bleeds. All right, so that is that. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Let me know what you think. And it's a bit of a long video this time, but I thought I'd just do the build because I thought people might want to know what that is. Thanks everyone for watching, and I hope the improvements keep coming. And